So let's say you've got a spreadsheet in Numbers that has a whole bunch of different items and you want to count them. You want to find out how much of each one there are. So here I just have a simple example of that. And actually in this table here this goes pretty long. It's 500 rows. So it's not going to be easy for me to figure out how many of each of these words are there. But I can do it using a formula pretty easily. So let's create a new table here. And I'll create a standard table. And let's shrink it down a bit. I only really need two columns here. And in this first column here, let's put the item we want. So let's count the number of apples that appear here. And then here's where I'm going to put the formula. So I start by typing equals. And I need a function. So whenever you need a function, just search for something. So we want to count the number of items. So let's start by searching for count. And sure enough, there are several different count functions here. Let's look at them. The first one here counts the number of arguments that contain numbers, numeric expressions, or dates. Not that, that's not what we want. Not empty, so count A isn't what we want. Count if will return the number of cells in a collection that satisfy a given condition. So this sounds like we want to see how many cells here equal something. So let's select count if. I could have typed it, but I'm just going to double click it there to insert it so I can see the parameters here. So the test array, so that's going to be well, we just want the whole column here. So I could select everything, but instead I'm going to do just click on B there and it'll show table 1, column B. Great. So what's the condition? So for the condition, let's we can see here in the examples how to do that, and we could see we've got things with quotes around them like quote equals ipsum here. So let's do that here. So we do quote equals apples like that. So that seems to fit the example here. And let's hit return and we get 66, which seems reasonable. That's what we would expect. Here we've got 500 items, so 66 is probably correct. And we could do the same thing. I can copy this and paste it here and then we edit the formula and then I can change it to say bananas. And we see there's 110 bananas there. But what would be nice is if we didn't have to have apples here and apples also here in the formula. You can see there below. So let's alter this a bit. And let's say what if instead of equals apples we simply put a link to this cell here. So table 1 column B and the condition is that they should be the same as A2, which is apples. And we see we get the same 66. If I were to, let's delete that cell there, copy this cell and paste it in here, we get 110 because while the column remains the same, we've only moved down vertically, so the column B remains the same there, this moves down from A2 to A3. So as we copy and paste into there, we get 0, but that's because we don't have anything here. So let's count oranges and 88. And we can just put pineapples there. And then we copy and paste. We get 102. So all it's doing is just taking the value of this, comparing it to this entire range here, and then giving us the total for each. So pretty simple way to count the number of items in a Numbers spreadsheet.